How to paint a watercolour robin, that's what this video is all about. Hello, I'm Paul Hopkinson, a professional wildlife artist and an online art tutor. You know, people often ask me what's my favourite bird to paint. Now my answer usually varies depending on what I'm working on really at the time, but I can tell you which bird I've painted most often, and that is the robin. Everyone is different and they all have their own unique characters as well. Now the video that follows is a little look at a small study which I did as a tutorial for my online school. This is a short, cut down version in which I share some hints, tips and also techniques for you. I hope you enjoy it, let's get started. Now the first thing we need to do is get the drawing onto the paper. I'm going to use some graphite backed paper to do this with, but if you prefer, just do it freehand, it's not a problem at all. But this enables us to get to the painting process that much quicker. So let's get the colours ready and mixed before we even start the painting. At least that way, there shouldn't be too many mistakes as we're going through the process itself. Now when painting the eye, I'm going to do this gradually by building up in layers. So we're going to add layer upon layer, then eventually get the detail on that very top. And the beak is all done through wet in wet technique, just kind of layering washes as we go through it. And for this stage, I'd like to use my 00 brush because we can get the finest of tips that way around as well. One other thing we need to do is use a damp clean brush in a few places so we can have a lift paint off or soften down. So the first thing I like to do is get the background colours onto the paper. Now these are my foundation layers. At least that way, once it's nice and dry, we've got something to build the detail on the top of. We'll be doing this by using wet in wet washes, by using some very vibrant, some very vivid colours, especially for the chest itself. As you can see, very, very bright. Then we've got to think about the detail over the top of that. Now we can add as many layers of detail as we want, that's entirely your choice. So we're going to use a mixture of different browns for the top of the head, and even down to like a watered down black. Yes, I do use black, it's a bit of one of those things that not everybody likes to use, but I like to use it in conjunction with other colours. We always need to consider the direction of the brush strokes as well, so you've got to really look at that reference photo and just concentrate on the direction all of these little lines go in. Because it's all these lines that help to form the shape of the robin. When we work on the chest, it's exactly the same process, however, we are working with some very bright colours. Now these colours will get toned down during the painting process. Then we'll add a darker layer, so we've had the lightest layer on the chest, now we're going to go for mid-tone, then we're going to go for the darkest layer on the chest, to kind of gradually build up the details as we go along. Then finally, we've got the grub to paint. I know that little bit of food this robin is ready and waiting to give to its little chick. So, how are we going to do that? We're going to add the browns in there first of all, some very bright red browns. Once we've got all the dark colours on there, then we'll even add a little bit of watercolour white, just to give that a little bit more sparkle and zing. And there we go, that's how to paint a robin in watercolour. However, if you want to, we can even add a background colour as well. I'm going to use a couple of different colours for that, so I don't like to add too many colours to the background. And because we're working on this as a circle, we want to think about how we're going to add this in. So we're going to have a graduated wash. So let me show you how I do that all the way through. So once we've wet the paper down, we can start adding the colours onto the paper and do it gently. But remember to wet the paper a few times beforehand though. At least that way, it will stay wetter longer. So once we've blended all that in, it's nice and dry. We'll add an outline to that as well. And then we'll have ourselves a finished painting of a robin. Now the full real-time video of this robin head painting is now available on my online school. I'll see you in another robin painting video, which you should be able to see to the top right-hand side.